from them.
And they're mine.
They're all over the place.
Not as big a problem in the colder months. Have you noticed that?
It should be.
Yeah, it should be, but it's not.
Well, because the shirts are thicker in the colder months.
96.5 KECO in Elk City, 707 on a finally Wednesday. 96.5. Did I just say that?
I wasn't really listening.
It's the early morning show, Nathan and Landry, and you can text us and weigh in. In fact, text us your weight. 225-9697.
Ding, 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 ding.
Go ahead and text us your weight.
Is there anything
Feel free.
More ridiculous than when the two boxers who are about to beat each other senseless come together in their ridiculous robes for the weigh-in? You have to have the official weigh-in. And then, of course, they hate each other. And so they scowl at each other. And then lately, you have these brawls that break out between their entourages. The boxers' entourages, they get into a brawl.
Good morning, you two animals. Hey, thank you.
At the weigh-in.
That is heartfelt on the text line. And that was sponsored by the Shinehart Wig Company.
Of Oneonta.
Of upstate New York.
Shinehart.
The Shinehart Wig Company is the sponsor of that first text. Every text has its own sponsor. And that's how we figured out how to make more money, is we have each individual text sponsored. So text us your weight, weigh in with your weight, and tell us who's sponsoring your text at 225-9697. Hey,
maybe the rules committees for football, they need to outlaw injuries. That would make the game a lot better because everybody's always hurt.
You know what struck me this year more than any other? I don't know if it actually happened or if I noticed it more, but it seems like before the first game ever hit, we kept hearing about players who were going to be out for 6 weeks.
Yes.
They were injured in practice. Does anybody like pizza? Boy, I do. I like pizza, but you know what? I'm 48 years old now, and so old Brew here's got to be careful about what he eats. But about a month ago, I wrapped my lips around something that was so delicious, I thought, well, surely I've just sinned. I thought, surely the pounds are going to be packed on. But then I was told, no, sir. We're talking about a gluten-free crust. We're talking about cauliflower. It's like I was packing a pound of cauliflower down my throat and into my stomach. It was a crust that was cauliflower-based. It wasn't wheat-based. And so I didn't have to worry about carbs, didn't have to worry about being gluten intolerant. And it tasted like it was deep fried. That's how good it was. You can dine in or get it to go at 66 to go, way out on the west side of Elk City, where 6 and 66 Y, between the two CUD locations. How about that?
Nathan, when did they change the football defensive position of defensive end to edge rusher?
I don't know.
Does the position of defensive end exist anymore?
We're always looking for new ways to say the same thing, Landry.
Edge rusher. Wasn't that just a defensive end? He's on the edge, and he's trying to rush. He's trying to get to the quarterback.
I don't know. Why is it commentators and people who talk about sports talk about the offensive side of the ball and the defensive side of the ball when they could just say offense, defense? Well, on offense, they're doing this. On defense, oh, no. Well, on the offensive side of the ball.
Is it because broadcasters are always trying to fill? And so instead of being brief.
No, it's because they
use as many words as possible.
No, I'm convinced they think it sounds cool.
Probably.
I don't know why. Why refer to LSU as the Bayou Bengals repeatedly?
You know, once a half, okay, that's fine. I would even once a quarter, I'm not crazy about it. But I would probably give it a pass. But twice, three times in the same quarter, in the same half?
I know, right? Uh-uh.
Chris Fowler, you're better than that. R. Mason Thomas plays football for the University of Oklahoma, and he is a junior edge rusher. In the old days, it was a defensive end. Now he's an edge rusher. Against Tulane, he had probably the single best series of any defensive player I've ever heard of. OU edge rusher R, and by the way, I love it. His name is R, Mason Thomas. In one Tulane series of four downs, Nathan, R. Mason Thomas had three sacks, and he batted down a pass on the fourth down.
They went for it on fourth down after three.
He may have batted it down on a third down, but I'm just saying he had three downs. He had a sack.
Oh, okay.
And
so
the fourth down, wherever it came in the series, he batted down a ball
on four plays. Is what you're saying, right?
Fourth play, right? In one series, he had three sacks and batted down a pass.
Landry, I'm looking at Oklahoma State University's remaining schedule. Mm-hmm. Two very intriguing matchups in the next two Saturdays. This coming Saturday, you've got number 14. I don't know if this is the USA poll or AP or who it is, but OSU is 14 in this particular poll. Number 14 taking on number 12, Utah.
Yeah, that's
How about that game?
That is a big game.
And then the week after that, I'll give you the rankings as of now. As of now, OSU is 14, Kansas State is 13. That's the next week. So this Saturday, OSU versus Utah, 14 versus 12. Then the next week, it's OSU 14 versus 13, Kansas State. So they play the number 12 team and then the number 13 team. They are the number 14 team. That's two good games in a row.
Over the last several seasons, OSU just sort of quietly works its way up into the top 10.
Mm-hmm.
And fields these really good teams.
I don't know how Gundy does it. Because he's not getting five-star recruits.
Maybe he's a really good coach.
Maybe. Those guys.
Maybe he's really good at developing talent, and maybe he's also really good at bringing in good coordinators and assistants.
Well, he does have quite a strong track record of that.
How many offensive coordinators at OSU have gone on to do that at other schools or become head coaches?
Fedora, Holgerson, Yursich.
And that's impressive.
Yeah.
That is very impressive.
96.5 KECO's The Early Morning Show. Have you guys heard of either Miley Cyrus or Bruno Mars? Landry, give us one of them. I don't care which one.
No preference.
Don't care.
Our song on the radio, but it don't sound the same.
This is a song Bruno Mars put out in about 2012 or 13 called When I Was Your Man, okay? It was a nice hit for him. Okay.
It's a nice little song.
Sure it is.
Nifty little song.
It was a nifty little song there. Yeah. Now, about a year and a half ago, a gal named Miley Cyrus came out with this song.
We were gold, kind of dream that can't be sold.
It was maybe the biggest song of 2023, Landry.
It was a big song.
She won her first Grammy for this song.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
It was a massive hit that everybody loved. Miley Cyrus and the song Flowers. Well, the song just before that was by Bruno Mars 10 years earlier called When I Was Your Man. Well, guess what? There are people involved with Bruno Mars' song who are suing Miley Cyrus saying, hey, part of your hit song came from our song. Miley Cyrus is being sued by a company alleging she copied Bruno Mars. In a lawsuit filed in Los Angeles on Monday, Tempo Music Investments alleged that Cyrus copied elements of Mars' track When I Was Your Man in her career-defining hit song Flowers. Quote, any fan of Bruno Mars' When I Was Your Man knows that Miley Cyrus' Flowers did not achieve all of that success on its own.
Mm.
Flowers duplicates numerous melodic, harmonic, and lyrical elements of When I Was Your Man, the lawsuit alleges. So what they're saying is that her song copied parts of Bruno Mars's song. Now, who is this outfit, Tempo Music Investments? That's what I wondered. Well, they had nothing to do with writing the song. They had nothing to do with producing the song. Here's what happened. The song, When I Was Your Man, was co-written by a guy whose name I can't find right now. Well, this guy later on sold his catalog of songs to Tempo Music Investments. After the fact. And so here comes Tempo Music Investments after the fact, and they've listened to the song over and over. They're probably vultures just listening to every song over and over and then comparing it to current hits, thinking, who can we sue? And now this Tempo Music Investments has come along and said, oh, we think that Miley Cyrus' song sounds a lot like the song we now own, so we're going to sue them and I guess try to make some money.
Do you remember, I think on this show a year or three ago, we may have mentioned something similar that went down between Kenny Loggins and Garth Brooks.
Yes, I remember that.
Garth's Standing Outside the Fire, which was on the In Pieces album from, what, fall of 93? Supposedly sounds a lot like Kenny Loggins' Conviction of the Heart. And it seems like we went back and listened to both, and I remember thinking, I don't get it, I don't hear it. But I'm not a musicologist. I'm not an expert in music. About melodic and symphonic. And what was the other thing? Bruno Mars'
lyrical.
People?
Lyrical.
Symphonic, melodic, and lyrical.
Yes.
I only know what two of those three things even mean.
And my first thought was, I didn't even hear a harmonica in either one of those songs.
Maybe we need more harmonica.
17 minutes after 7 o'clock, 96.5 KECO's The Early Morning Show. Listen, we've gotten three texts this morning. And well, hold on. I think you two guys should have a weigh-in each morning, right when you get started, sponsored by Weight Watchers. That's a good idea.
But I don't have a robe.
And then one guy says, really? 24 hours later, you're still stuck on Bayou Bengals? Stuck on you. Got a feeling down deep in my soul that I just can't lose.
I wish we played more Lionel.
Yes,
Richie.
I'm on my way. Mighty glad you weighed. How about that's a weigh-in song? I'm mighty glad you weighed.
Have you seen Kenny Loggins lately?
No. Kenneth Loggins stopped getting surgery. Have you seen Jessica Simpson lately?
No.
I saw a picture of her yesterday. It just popped up on my on the computer.
Uh-huh.
And the first thought I said to myself, "Oh no. Don't." That's what I said. Please, come on, Jessica.
You know,
if surgeries.
If you and I worked in television, we would have to color our hair.
Yeah.
It's illegal for male broadcasters to have gray hair, right? Actually, speaking of Chris Fowler, he has some gray in his hair. Kirk Herbstreit,
yeah,
his hair is getting brighter.
That's why they
Brooks' hair is getting darker, by the way.
That's why they got rid of Scott Pelley at CBS Evening News.
Did they can him? Is he still working for CBS in any way?
Oh, yeah, he still
does
some
podcast.
He does some 60-minute stuff.
Special
reporting.
Hey,
here's some. I like this. This is some good news. All right, you ready for this? Good morning, guys. As women, we don't usually tell our weight, but proud of my weight loss. Used to weigh 232 pounds, but now weigh 153.
Oh, wow.
Proud of myself. I'm not good at math. 53, 63, 73, 83, wow. 93, 2003, 2013, 2020. Is that 80 pounds?
Well, there are probably a lot of people out there who would like to know the secret to losing
80 pounds?
Weight. Wow.
How did you do that? What's a tree's What is a tree's favorite song?
What's that?
Don't Stop Believing.
Nah.
Good morning, guys. Women don't usually like to tell our weight, but I'm proud of my weight loss. I used to weigh 232 pounds, but now weigh 153. That is technically, I just did them at 79 pounds.
Goodness.
How did you lose 79 pounds? That's what I want to know. Text me and let me know. And let us know who your text sponsor is. Who is sponsoring your text? 225-9697, 20 minutes after the hour, 69 degrees where I am.
If it's Bruno Mars, make sure you get his permission first.
We're going to hit this afternoon about 95. We're in for a 3 to 4 day stretch of some really warm weather.
Because my heart breaks a little when I hear your name. It all
and
just
I be like, ooh. When you call Brock Landry, he knows you're not going to call singing a song unless it's the blues because you need hoses.
Bought you flowers.
Maybe that was it.
I should have brought flowers.
Held your hand. Should have gave you all my hours.
I don't hear a bit.
When I had the chance.
Did they trademark and copyright the word flowers?
We can't use flowers.
But wait a minute. I thought Neil Diamond and Barbara Streisand did that in about 1980.
Statute of limitations. It ran out, Nathan. Too old. You have to renew that every 3.5 hours.
Well, Brock knows. When you call him, if you're singing a song, it's the blues because you need hoses. American Hose and Supply for all your hoses and fittings inside the Camrock building next to Fred's Steakhouse.
Nathan and Landry will keep talking on the Early Morning Show right after this.
Do you need funds to make a major purchase, consolidate debt, or for home renovations? Come to Oklahoma Bank and Trust for competitive interest rates on personal loans. Stop by our Clinton or Arapahoe branch to meet our experienced lending staff, where qualified borrowers can receive affordable funding. We will work closely with you to understand your financial situation and lending needs. Oklahoma Bank is here to help make your plans reality. Borrow what you need for the things you want from your friendly bank, OB&T member FDIC, and equal housing lender.
If they call me, they're expecting me to get whatever task done. To a farmer, a tractor, combine, gets him up and running. He's back in the field, makes some money. Guy in the oil field, their piece of equipment's running again. That makes some money. Solves that problem. I'm Brock Kalk, and my company is American Hose and Supply. We sell all types of industrial hose and fittings, oil field or agriculture. So if your farmer need a hose built, you can come in. We'll build it. You're a oil field customer and need us to come out and see you, we'll come out and see you and take an order or pick up a hose, build it, bring it back to you. If we're competitive on price, we say we'll bring it to you. We'll do whatever it takes to get it to you, make life easier on you. Or you can call us to solve a problem. Hey, can you get this? Why wouldn't you? My company is American Hose and Supply. Come by and see us at 2111 South Main, Elk City, Oklahoma, in Camrock Building next to Fred's. Or call me at 580-821-4413. 821-4413.
You got to break a few eggs to bake a cake, but the result is fantastic. We're remodeling Barber Dyson Ford, and you're going to love what we're doing at the place. But don't let the construction scare you away. We're not slowing down for 1 second. The lot is busting at the seams with more inventory than anyone from OKC to Amarillo, and we're determined to move it out. So the prices are low and the trade-in cash is high. It's the end of the summer with construction sale at Barber Dyson Ford, where the remodel won't get in the way of your great deal. Online at BarberDysonFord.net.
Briley Baca is an investment advisor representative of and advisory services offered through Royal Fund Management, LLC, an SEC-registered investment advisor.
He remembers his dad coming home from the rigs in the early 1980s with his coveralls covered in grease and oil. Then he followed his dad's footsteps into the oil field. He likes the work and appreciates what it's done for his family. But he likes something else a lot more. He and his wife have 3 grown kids who have kids of their own now. They love playing with those grandbabies. Soon, they'll see their grandkids all they want. Might even fix up the house and go on that Caribbean honeymoon they couldn't afford 35 years ago. When his family was young, he contacted some people who put a plan together for him. He and his wife sacrificed and worked the plan all these years. Their patience and persistence are about to pay off. Advanced Financial Strategies in Clinton, retirewithbaca.com, or 323-6800. All the work you're doing now should lead to something better someday.
If your computer won't go, call an ITL Pro. Innovative Technology, 243-1559. Online at ITLPros.com.
Ready for another dose of radio caffeine? Here comes the early morning show on KEZO.
It sounded odd going up. 25 minutes after the hour, 96.5. KECO's the early morning show. Let's see. The listener who said that she lost 79 pounds. So I said, that's great. How'd you do it? By the way, she said her sponsor is herself for this text. Lost just because of health reasons. A lot of change in diet. A lot of fruit and vegetables, especially celery. 79 pounds. That's fantastic. What did the fisherman say to the magician? And then I don't have the punchline.
Oh.
They sent in.
The fisherman.
What did the. What? Let's see if we can figure it out. What did the fisherman say to the magician? I caught you in the act? What do you think? I caught you in the act.
Fisherman say to them, I caught your act?
I caught your act or I caught you in the act?
That's pretty good.
That's okay. no, here's the answer. Okay, so what? Hold on, let me get the thing ready. Oh. So what did the fisherman say to the magician? Pick a cod, any cod. Cod, the C-O-D.
Hey, what did Miley Cyrus say to Bruno Mars?
Remembered I can buy myself flowers.
Please don't sue me, I'll go bankrupt. Hey, if she goes bankrupt, she may need financial help from Oklahoma Bank and Trust, their friendly bank. Clinton and Arapahoe, part of the community. You'll see them out and around. Notice what I said. I didn't say out and about. I said out and around. I went a different way. Oklahoma Bank and Trust, your friendly bank.
Clinton, and Arapaho. Is Liam, am I pronouncing his name correctly? Liam Hemsworth? Is it Liam? You know, Thor's brother? Is he just famous for being a famous guy's brother? And I could not tell you a single thing he's done.
And having dated Miley Cyrus.
I didn't know that they had been a couple, but I saw a little video. It's a remix, a short remix.
You know what Josh Heupel, coach of Tennessee, and OU coach Brent Venables have in common? They both left Norman, Oklahoma as disgruntled coordinators. Josh Heupel was actually fired. And then Brent Venables started as OU's co-defensive coordinator with Mike Stoops. Then Mike Stoops left to become head coach at Arizona. That didn't work out. And then Bob brought his brother Mike Stoops back to OU. So he and Mike were going to once again be co-defensive coordinators. And Brent said, nah, I've done that before. I think I'll go somewhere else. And he went to Clemson and helped Dabo Sweeney win two national championships. And then he's now OU's head coach. But it's well known Josh Heupel still has a real burr under his saddle for OU, which doesn't that mean for Bob Stoops?
How do we know that?
Because everybody says he's got a burr under his saddle.
On the offensive side of the ball or the defensive side of the ball?
On the football side of the ball. There's a story in the Oklahoman today about how Bradford and White and Murray and Mayfield, they all have Heisman trophies, but none of them have the thing they really want, which is what Josh Heupel has, which is a ring. Josh Heupel won a national championship. He didn't win a Heisman. He won a national title.
Came in number two.
Yeah, he's second. But he won a national championship. And those other guys who won the Heisman, and how, oh, they would just love to have that ring. You know what occurred to me? 2 weeks from yesterday, Landry,
I'm sorry, go ahead.
2 weeks from yesterday is the first day of October. Mm-hmm. What that means is we're going to enter the fourth quarter of 2024. Now, yes, it's annoying. It really is annoying when the stores all come out with their Christmas stuff the day after July 4th. Because they say, why can't we just enjoy now? Why can't we focus on now? And I understand that it is a little bit annoying. But you do have to plan for the future. And so in two more weeks, when we roll into October, we're going to roll into the fourth quarter of this year. And so people are going to start looking at 2025. How crazy is that? 2025, because we're going into the fourth quarter of the year.
You got to play all four. Remember, you got to play all four.
And what occurs to me is, look, you have to plan everything. School, a teacher can't show up to class one day and say, all right, well, you know, what should we study today? You have to make plans. You have to have lesson plans. A sergeant can't say, oh, gee, what are we going to train on today, you privates? And privates can't turn around and say, gee, Sarge, why don't we just live for today instead of planning for the next warlet? You can't do that. You just can't do that. So what you got to try to do, you've got to live for today but plan for tomorrow. And I don't know if I made that up or if I'm repeating what I heard somebody else say. And if I am repeating what somebody else said, please, Bruno Mars's people, don't sue me. But you've got to live for today. Yes, I must live today. There are things I have to do today. And I want to enjoy today. And I want to soak it in. But at the same time, I have to get ready for tomorrow. I have to plan. And in just 2 weeks, we're going to roll into the fourth quarter of this year. Which we're going to start, I guarantee you, 2 weeks from today, everybody's going to be talking about Halloween. And the day after Halloween, November 1st, it is full-on holiday season. We're thinking about Thanksgiving. We're thinking about Christmas. And, yes, that will lead us to New Year's because that's all going to happen in less than 2 months. But something else is that businesses start looking at, okay, 2025. Schools start looking at 2025. Civic organizations. You've got to look at what's coming up because these things that happen, when an event happens, whether it's Dust Bowl Days in Sayre, whether it's Pioneer Day at Cheyenne, whether it's the Fall Festival in Elk City this weekend, which we're going to talk about in a few more minutes when we put a spotlight on Elk City. But all these big events take much time, much planning, much forethought. And so you have to plan ahead. You do. You have to. So how do you strike that balance? Yeah, I want to live for today, but plan for tomorrow. How do I do that? Well, I don't have the answer, but I know you've got to do both. You need to do both. If all you're ever doing is planning for what comes next, you're not living. You need to live your life. You got a job, you got kids, you got a home, you got things you want to do, things you have to do that has to be done today. But if you fail to think about tomorrow, well, you're going to be in trouble tomorrow or next week or next month when the big thing takes place. So let me encourage everybody. Old Uncle Nathan is going to encourage everybody. Live for today, but plan for tomorrow. And text us at 225-9697. Please, for the love of you. Please, for the love of Pete, don't put your tree up early. Okay, but how early is early? So when are you supposed to put your Christmas tree up? Are you supposed to wait until December? Are you supposed to wait until December 20th? You ever watch the TV show or the movie where somebody is literally going out Christmas Eve to get their Christmas tree? Boy, that seems like a waste. My kids, they really get on me, I mean, about the 1st of November. They get on, oh, Dad, can we put the tree up? Can we put the, okay, well, that's fine if you want to. That's fine. Now, look, because it is a lot of work, and you want it up. I've come to see through the years that it just lets you stretch it out and enjoy it longer. If you want to start listening to Christmas music about Halloween, it's your business, I guess. And it's your tree, your house. You can do what you want. But when are you supposed to put your tree up? When is too early? Not Thanksgiving like you did last year. Not Thanksgiving. I did it before Thanksgiving last year. But you know what? That's what the kids wanted. And, you know, I actually found myself enjoying it. So I have a feeling, I just have a feeling that right after Halloween, maybe that weekend, the tree may be going up. Because you know what? We enjoyed it. The kids enjoyed it, and it stretched out. It stretched out our holiday enjoyment. And it allowed us to stay in the season longer. I really enjoyed that. These guys can have all the championship rings they want. I have something better. The Early Morning Show with Nathan and Landry Brewer, sponsored by Lunker's Septic Tank Service. Let me bow down and give it up to that text. our earlier listener who texted in, she'd lost 79 pounds, and we asked her how she did it, and she said mostly change of diet. Mostly change of diet. She said, she followed up with a text. Diabetes 2, type 2 diabetes. Had to lose for health. She said, you put your mindset to do it. Okay, that's number one. You got to make the decision. A lot of people say, oh, I sure wish I could lose. Boy, I'd sure like to. There's a difference in saying you need to or you want to. That's one thing. But changing your mind and saying, I am going to do it. That's number one. And that's what this person did. I'm diabetic, type 2, had to lose it for health. You put your mindset to do it, you can. Guess my sponsors, Grandview Pharmacy, love Colby and all their friendly staff, wouldn't change. Hey, amen to that. Grandview Pharmacy and gifts. That's where old brew goes when it's pill time. Well, Colby, the kids are sick. Well, Colby, I'm sick. Well, Colby, got to get a colonoscopy. Text me, let me know, 225-9697. 735 on a finally funky, fresh Wednesday morning, 69 degrees on our way to more. Your weather breakdown in a few more. We'll put a spotlight on Elk City. Oil field companies, they pay because they're oil field companies. Oil field money is a little different. But man, when you're a farmer, farming's different. You'll whittle on price. Camrock knows that. They know that. They've been around the farmers, supplied farmers for years. When you need it for an engine, farmers, when you need it for an engine, oil field companies, when you need it for an engine, buy in bulk. Save yourself time and money per unit. Camrock Supply. Go to them next to Fred's Steakhouse or call and they'll come to you. Camrock Supply. Online, camrocksupply.com.
While you wait for the early morning show to return on KECO, please enjoy these complimentary copies of National Geographic.
Alignment is very important. I mean, it causes the wear on your tires. So if you just let it go, the tires, instead of saying a 60,000 miles, will only last 30 or 40,000. It's called toe. It's where the tires are pigeon-toed. They're turned in, they're turned out. One may be one way, one may be the other. We always shake down the front end to make sure there's no loose parts because our roads are so nice and smooth out here that they do get some parts that wear out a little quicker. Uneven wear, edge wear, and shaking. Rough roads, potholes, constructions, and riding in the country. It all is tough on your vehicle. We have a gentleman who's been here nearly 11 years. Very knowledgeable, knows what's going on. We probably average 5 alignments a day. Something, honestly, needs to probably be done every year. L&R Tire. It's 1204 South Main, Elk City, Oklahoma.
The home of Bridgestone Firestone Tires.
At L&R Tire, we'll take good care of your vehicle.
Yeah, farmers can be pretty tough. Oilfield companies, they need it as long as we give them a fair price. Hey, let's go. Farmers, they're pretty tough because it's a hard world in farming, you know, in the farming market. It's tough, so they're going to do all they can to get the best deal they can, and we're going to give it to them. Everything for maintenance on your equipment, changing your oils, you need some antifreeze, you need some hydraulic oil, any kind of grease. We got the bolts and fasteners now. We're opening up electrical fittings, zip ties, penetrating oils, you know, windshield washers, all your shop towels, hand wash stuff, you know, any type of stuff like that. Anything for like a maintenance shop or something like that where you're doing maintenance work. Just getting everything else that we can to make us a one-stop shop. And if we don't have it there, we're going to get it for you somehow or another. And it's not going to take 2 weeks to get it. Camrock is the name of the company. It's 2111 South Main, Elk City, south of Fred's Steakhouse. I'm Ronnie Redd. Myself, Brock Kalk, and Casey Miller are your owners at Camrock. Three local guys just looking to do business with our community.
A person who has never smiled can start smiling. There's just a look on their face that completely changes. When we get them a mirror and show them their new smile, there's nothing that warms my heart more. I had a gentleman in his 50s, and his whole life he never had a front tooth. His front tooth was stuck up in the bone. He had been to dentists before, but nobody really talked to him about his options. That was just the most rewarding thing, and afterwards he sent me the sweetest card about how the Lord put a smile on his heart, but I put a smile on his face, and that's pretty rewarding.
I'm Dr. Jamie Cameron at Southwest Dentistry and Cosmetics in Weatherford, and on Mondays at Liberty Dental in Carnegie. Our website is swdentalok.com, or just Google us.
Southwest Dentistry and Cosmetics, where we treat you like family and do life-changing dentistry. And I've got to say, it's pretty life-changing for us whenever we see you with your new smile.
He was a school teacher and a missionary for almost 20 years. Not the sort of thing you do for the money or the glamour. That's why people trust him. Like the gentleman who wanted to buy a grain bin from him but couldn't decide which one. So he gave our man a check, and he said he'd let him know later which one he picked. Our guy prefers to look people in the eye. He'll drive 4 hours to hand you a quote. Hand it to you. He thinks doing business face-to-face is the best way. Having your own grain bin on site makes all the sense in the world. You don't have to find space somewhere else for your grain. Storing it at your own place makes it really convenient. And it'll make you money. But the real reasons people buy grain bins from Wall Equipment? They trust a guy named Reggie, and because it's easy to do business with the Wall family. The website is wallequip.com. The building is the big silver bin on I-40 east of Clinton, just west of Love's. The Wall family is in business to solve your problems.
Restaurants and feedlots, coffee shops and cafes, grocery stores and convenience stores. The Penny News is there, waiting for you to take it home.
Nathan and Landry Brewer are so talented, we're thinking about actually paying them to do this gig.
Oh, that's bad.
No, that's good.
How come?
The Early Morning Show continues right now.
Do, do, do. 20 away, 96.5. KECO's The Early Morning Show. If your power goes out at midnight, call Carter Electric. Why? Why midnight? Are they waiting up? Well, they've got 24-hour emergency service. I know that. Carter Electric. 20% chance of showers and thunderstorms today. Otherwise, partly to mostly sunny. High of 95. It's going to be a cooker. South winds 10 to 20. Tonight, 20% chance of thunder. Otherwise, mostly clear, 73. And then tomorrow, bump it up to a 30% chance of rain. Isn't this great? We need the rain. 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms tomorrow. Otherwise, sunny and hot. Oh, man. You know, my bold prediction is going to be in danger. We're going to hit about 98 or 99 tomorrow. I said, look, 2 weeks ago, I said we're done with 100s. And in fact, I went further. And I said after this week, we may be done with 90s. It's pretty bold. So today, 95, tomorrow, 98 or 99, and Friday, 98. So we're going to see. Right now, though, 69 degrees where I am. Skies mostly clear. Have you noticed not only are the days getting shorter at the end, but it's getting lighter later in the morning. So it doesn't get light until about the time we go on the air. But sun's coming up, mostly clear skies, humidity about 79, south winds already 15. Have you ever had creme brulee? Have I ever asked you that? Have
no,
you?
Probably.
Oh, man. I had it. I've had it one time, and I will never forget it. It was about 2 months ago in Leedy, Oklahoma. Kelly came back. She said, hold on, I'll be right back. And she went in the kitchen. She brought it back, and she was holding it in her left hand, and she's got this blowtorch in her right hand. She's, you know, blowing the top of it. She hands it to me, gives me a spoon, and I crunch my way through the top, and then I mix it up, and you got this really smooth and rich and creamy bottom, and I have that crunchy on top, and I mix it up, and I take one spoonful, and I put it in my mouth, and I had to just pause to enjoy what was going on there. It was so good. Here's the deal. Julia Child was this great teacher of cooking back in the 70s, 80s. Well, Kelly's grandmother was a Julia Child flunky, learned a bunch of stuff from Julia Child. And then Grandma taught Kelly how to cook. And now she's cooking it up at Dry Creek Steakhouse and Lodge in Leedy. Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday for lunch. Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday for lunch, Dry Creek Steakhouse and Lodge. This is what happens when ranchers cook steak. 96.5 KECO's The Early Morning Show. Nathan and Julie and you. It's time to put a spotlight on Elk City, brought to you by the Elk City Convention Center, Elk City Chamber of Commerce, Elk City Tourism, the guys and gals who will be, ultimately, putting up the Christmas lights. City of Elk City, there you go. Put a spotlight on Elk City. We got a lot to talk about. Julie, good morning. Go right ahead. Julie, good morning.
Looking forward to putting a spotlight on this week, because it's the 51st annual Fall Festival. This is going to be September 21st through the 22nd, what y'all been waiting for, at the Elk City Convention Center. Saturday, the times are 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., and Sunday, 12 to 5. It's free admission, of course. Crafts, decor, original arts, high school art exhibit, furniture, stylish clothing, and delicious food. For more information, you can call the Elk City Chamber of Commerce. They are the ones that put this on at 580-225-0207. And just in time for the butterflies that are heading down to Mexico, the Elk City Carnegie Library is having butterfly fun. September 26th at 4 p.m. This is for ages 5 to 12, and it's presented by the OSU Extension Office. Western Oklahoma Bulls versus OK Servants, or is it Servants?
Servants. Gotta be Servants.
Okay. September 28th, 6 p.m., Arrowhead Center. Tickets will be available soon. The 51st annual Route 66 Flea Market is going to be October 4th, 5th, and 6th at Ackley Park in Elk City. For booth space, you can call Beverly Jordan at 580-339-0668. And this is sponsored by the Western Oklahoma Historical Society. Yes, indeed.
Can I go back over this now?
I just want to talk about some stuff. Do whatever you want.
Well, but it's your segment, and I like to share. The Fall Festival is one of those really neat events that, and I know people from out of town come to this. I remember being in college at Southwestern at Weatherford 20 years ago, something like that. No, it was longer than that. It was 25 years ago, maybe. And one of my professors who lives in Weatherford was talking to me, we had the Fall Festivals this weekend in Elk City. My wife and I are going to go because we like to go to, it's a different kind of a thing. All right, in the spring, you get the Southwest Farm and Home Expo, which is lots of agriculture stuff and lots, you know, stuff like that. But Fall Festival, they really celebrate, the arts. They celebrate interior stuff, interior design. It's a little different, and I like that. And it's the kind of thing that whether it's a woman and her gal pals can go to, lots of husbands and wives go just to look at maybe stuff for the home. But it's a celebration of the arts, and it's a reminder, fall is coming, changing of the seasons, get ready. It helps you start getting ready for the holiday. So I always really like the Fall Festival.
About 9,000 people last year at this event.
Wow.
Now, that's including vendors, but 9,000. This is a really big event. 51 years.
That's a long time. It reminds me of butterflies. Butterfly fun. Are butterflies the kind of thing that just make everybody smile? Whenever you see a butterfly in person, or you're watching a TV show or a movie, and there are butterflies, what is it about butterflies that makes everybody happy?
Well, they're not loud. They're soft. They're pretty to look at.
Yes, they are. You know what else? Harmless. Nobody's ever scared of a butterfly.
That's right.
And you know what? They float, which is what Muhammad Ali reminded us. Float like a butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
They don't sting like bees. Bees are
scary. On the air.
Bees may be necessary. Sure, they're necessary, but they're scary because they sting people. But butterflies? Harmless. Beautiful. They're really lovely, and they make everybody happy. Butterfly fun. September the 26th, 4 p.m., Elk City Carnegie Library, the OSU Extension Office. Here's what I've come to realize through the years. These OSU Extension Offices are busy. They're always doing something, whether it's, you know, whether
4-H.
It's, every county's got them. It's an interesting backstory. And was it Greg Hartman was telling me the story one time when I had to sit in for Jimmy? Anyway, Butterfly Fun, September 26th. It's for kids ages 5 to 12 at the Elk City Carnegie Library. And it's presented by the OSU Extension Office. We're already at basketball season. How did that happen? Boy, I don't know. Great question, Nathan.
I was just thinking we are right here in football season.
I know, but that's what I'm saying.
We're going to sprinkle in a little bit of basketball.
So the Western Oklahoma Bulls versus the Oklahoma Servants, September the 28th. September 28th. And then, of course, October just around the corner. I mean, it'll be here before we know it, 51st. Wait a minute, 51st?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's
they started at the same time.
They started, wow. So you've got the fall festival this weekend. And then, what is it, the first? Yeah, first weekend in October is the 51st annual Route 66 Flea Market. Sponsored by the Western Oklahoma Historical Society. That'll be in Ackley Park.
Yes, and you can call Beverly Jordan, the number that I gave. So if you want to be a vendor out there. Okay, do we have time for...
Sure.
Okay. Well, there was an online poll given by U.S. News that finds many parents worried about their kids finding friends. This is by Dennis Thompson. Many parents worry that their kids aren't popular enough or they aren't making the right friends, a new survey finds. About 1 in 5 parents say their child, age 6 to 12, has no friends or not enough friends, according to the result of the University of Michigan Health C.S. Mott Children's Hospital National Poll on Children's Health. However, 2 in 3 parents say that it's important that their child's friends come from families like theirs, something that could get in the way of a kid making new friendships. Keeping friendships exclusive to certain circles can prevent a child from developing broader perspectives, open-mindedness, and better social skills, Mott Poll co-director Sarah Clark said. School is often viewed as a place where children will encounter and form connections with peers with different backgrounds, ideas, customs, and ways of thinking, Clark said in a university news release. Limiting a child's friends to only those from similar backgrounds may hamper their ability and comfort in navigating diverse networks in the future. Most commonly, parents want their kids to find friends from families with similar parenting styles.
Mm-hmm.
But more than a third of parents prefer that friends come from their families with certain political or religious affiliation, the poll found.
Really?
Yes.
Political? Really?
About 9 out of 10 parents believe their child would like to make new friends. More than half of parents reported at least one factor that makes it tough for their kid to develop new friendships. First one, about 1 in 5 say that shyness or social awkwardness has hampered their child's ability to make new friends.
I sympathize with that.
Another 15% say the other kids are mean to their child. Absolutely. Making it tough to find friendships.
Some kids are turds.
Just under 10% said their child's disability or medical condition makes friendships more challenging. Some parents say their children face barriers in making friends, such as personality, social anxiety, medical conditions, or just not having as many opportunities. Most commonly, parents say they arrange play dates or outings, enroll their child in activities, or give their kid advice on how to make friends. About a quarter of parents try to help by befriending other parents with kids the same age. Be careful. Overbearing parents could make it worse for kids who are shy, socially awkward, or suffering from social anxiety. Parents should expect and allow children to make mistakes, intervening only in matters of safety.
It's always been interesting to me to watch little kids because, generally speaking, historically, little kids make friends quicker than adults do because you just throw kids together. Hey, you want to play? Okay. And it goes like that. But increasingly, we did a story yesterday about how one psychologist said record numbers of young people, let's say teenagers, record numbers are saying they're sad or depressed or unhappy. I think it's unhappy was the word. And a lot of it had to do with if you're, a lot of that was an overreact. If you're cutting off people who you consider toxic, you do that enough and finally you're going to find yourself isolated. You're not talking to anybody.
Right. Yeah.
Well, the things that you mentioned, of course, some kids do have disabilities, which literally makes it difficult to interact with others. Other people, kids are just mean. And what I would say, I have only one piece of parenting advice because I really don't know what I'm doing. But I have one piece of parenting advice. It's really, it's a request to every parent. Please tell your kids to be nice. And that's it. Tell your kids, be nice. You don't have to be friends with everybody, but be nice to everybody. And then that makes friendship more likely.
Well, when you get out there in the real world and you have a job, actually, even before you graduate from high school and you're out there in society and you have a job, are those employees your coworkers? Are they like your friends in your circle? No, they're not. It's very diverse.
Mm-hmm.
I remember going off to college, and I came from an all-white school, very small rural town, Yale, Oklahoma. And when I got off to college, I was like, oh, they don't look like me. And I was actually okay with it, and I liked the diversification there in college. But I will say something that really was eye-opening to me is when I had to work with prisoners. And when the city used to contract with Granite, the prison,
well,
and...
Yeah, what Julie used to tell me was, these prisoners, I can't believe how much alike we are. Not really. No, she didn't say that at all.
But boy,
no.
Does that open up your, just everything.
Julie, earlier we had some texters. First of all, and we may have missed her by now, happy 7th birthday to Azalea, your favorite listener. 7th birthday today to Azalea, going to Elk City Elementary.
Aww.
This is your birthday song. It doesn't last too long. Hey, hopefully we
happy
did
birthday.
Not miss her. And then we had another listener. We were saying, feel free to weigh in by giving us your weight. Text us your weight.
Who would do that?
One person did, and it was a woman. And she said, normally women don't like to do that, but she said, I'm proud of my weight loss. She lost 79 pounds.
Wow, great job.
And I said, how? You know, how'd you do it? And she said, mostly it was diet. She's just switched to a lot of fruit and vegetables. A lot of celery.
It's mind over matter, isn't it?
And she went on to talk about how much she loves Colby Brewster and Grandview Pharmacy.
Hey, you could spend a whole segment on weight loss.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we could spend a whole show.
I could weigh in on that.
Let's see. And then earlier, the Christmas tree texter,
yeah,
who begged me not to put it up too early. She followed up and said, I don't mind the Christmas tree after Thanksgiving. I just can't do Christmas music for a month and a half.
No, I can't either.
Boy, I can. I love it.
I think it's forced at our house.
The kids love it. And don't you love our kids?
Come on. I just don't want to listen to that. After Thanksgiving, yes. And to December 31st.
And then I gave a prediction about the weather, and the guy said, if you're wrong about your prediction, you should walk barefoot on a bed of hot coals. This text sponsored by Kidda Fire Extinguishers.
What was the prediction?
I said, 2 weeks ago, I said, we're done with 100s. And then last week, I said, after this week, we're done with the 90s.
I don't think so. I think it's going to come back in.
Boy, things are on fire at Barbara Dyson Ford with all those pickup trucks. All of them, one right after another. Get your truck. The end of summer blowout. Barbara Dyson Ford, northeast part of Elk City, online, barbaradysonford.net. Julie, quickly, how do people get this information from this week's Spotlight?
Elk City Chamber of Commerce.
Facebook page, right?
Yes.
Good morning, sunny and 71. This is the Paragon Morning News. I'm Jared Aethub. An Eric man has been charged in Beckham County District Court after allegedly sending inappropriate pictures to a 14-year-old female. According to a probable cause affidavit, 47-year-old Tony Ray Glassburn of Eric has been charged with one count of lewd or indecent proposals to a child under the age of 16 and one count of violation of Oklahoma statute via computer on September 12th after allegedly sending the images to the teenager via Facebook Messenger. The court documents show that the Beckham County Sheriff's Office was notified of the pictures on September 10th. An investigation into the case revealed that the mother of the teen messaged the defendant and asked about the pictures. He claimed at first his Facebook account was hacked, but later apologized and said he was drunk. Glassburn further stated that he hoped she did not contact authorities. If convicted, Glassburn could spend up to 20 years in prison plus fines. Damaged highway bridges had the attention of Oklahoma transportation commissioners at their recent meeting. They were updated by Transportation Department Executive Director Tim Gatz on a recent bridge hit to the Randall Avenue Bridge over I-40 in Elk City. An over-height vehicle carrying an excavator hit the bridge on August 17th, resulting in several damaged bridge beams and spans closing Randall Avenue. A $670,000 emergency contract was awarded and work began last Thursday, narrowing eastbound I-40 to one lane for 2 weeks. Commissioners also voted to approve a contract to replace the Tower Bridge on Route 66, U.S. Highway 281, over an unnamed creek just north of Hinton in Caddo County. That $3 million project will begin in mid-September to widen and replace the bridge and will close the bridge at Broadway Avenue in Hinton with a local detour in place. Crews estimate completion to be done in the spring, well in advance of the Route 66 centennial, which is in 2026. These stories and much more on our Facebook page and website, seeing sunny skies outside in 71. This has been the Paragon Morning News. I'm Jared Atho.
Usually the victim is doubled over with abdominal pain, but not this time. This time was a little different. The poor guy couldn't stop throwing up. It was Wednesday night, and it got so bad he went to the ER. Turns out he had kidney stones. On Thursday, he saw Aaron Doherty at Urology Associates, Western Oklahoma. On Friday, Dr. Cole Wooten performed surgery. And just like that, the suffering stopped. Nearly one out of every nine adults will go through the pain of having kidney stones. It's a miserable condition to suffer through. If it happens to you, it's not a statistic, it's a painful fact. You want prompt assessment and prompt treatment. That's what Dr. Cole Wooten and urological nurse practitioners Tracy Lane and Aaron Doherty provide. On Facebook, search Urology Associates Western Oklahoma. The office is in Elk City at 522 North Main. When you're suffering, you want relief sooner, not later.